In this video, you'll see how you can enable multi-account insight aggregation with Amazon DevOps Guru. With this capability, you can enable DevOps Guru across multiple accounts in an organization. Register a delegated administration account with trusted access, and then view insights for accounts across the organization from the delegated administrator account. For this demo, we'll set up three accounts, A, B, and C, within the same organization. We're logged into account B and will provision some resources using an AWS Cloud9 environment. We'll create a new environment. Let's name the environment and proceed to the next step. We'll retain the default settings. Let's move to the next step and create the environment. To start, let's perform a clone of the AWS samples GitHub repository. Let's check the files in the repository. Let's enter the directory and check its files. We'll navigate to the Generate Lambda DevOps Guru Insights folder. Within this folder, we see two files. The Lambda Code Python file features a message when returning a successful status code of 200. The Lambda Template YAML file represents an AWS Serverless Application Model, or AWS SAM, template that creates a Lambda function and uses an Amazon EventBridge rule to schedule the function once each minute. Let's deploy the template code. We'll name the stack. We will keep the default region. Now let's confirm the changes and save the configuration. Now we can deploy the change set. The DevOps Guru Sample Anomalous Lambda Stack has been created. Let's take a look at the resources we provisioned. We'll view the Lambda function first. Here we can see the Lambda function and its source code. Let's also check the EventBridge rule. This rule targets the Lambda function once each minute. We're done with account B and can move on to account C. For the purposes of this demonstration, we've gone ahead and created a similar Cloud9 environment on account C with a T3 small instance type. For this account, we'll set up a serverless application. First, let's install a JQ package to perform JSON searches. Let's assign the region value to an environment variable. Let's view the environment variable. Next, we'll export and assign the AWS region, using the same one where account C is located. Let's install the requests package. We'll clone the same GitHub repository as before. Let's view the directory and access the Generate DevOps Guru Insights folder. Let's view the subfolders. Before we use any of the file code, let's create a stack called MyServerless Stack. We can check the stack creation in AWS CloudFormation. The stack creation is in progress. The stack is composed of several resources and events. The stack creation is now completed. Let's review its resources. Several resources were created, including an API gateway that invokes a Lambda function, which, in turn, performs queries and updates in a DynamoDB table. Let's review the stack's outputs. The stack contains two API URLs as outputs responsible for creating and listing records. Let's return to the Cloud9 shell. Next, we'll populate the Amazon DynamoDB table that was created as a part of our CloudFormation stack. Let's supply the code for the DynamoDB resource. We'll extract the table name. Let's view the MyServerless Stack Shops Table Monitor Operations table in DynamoDB. Here's the table we just created. The table is empty, so let's return to the Cloud9 environment to populate it with some records. This sed command updates the populate shops DynamoDB table JSON file with the DynamoDB table name that we just created. This is done so we can populate the table with the data in the JSON file in the next steps. Let's view the contents of the JSON file and make sure the DynamoDB table name is populated. Let's validate that the DynamoDB table name is correctly populated in the JSON file. Finally, let's populate the table using the batch write item command. Let's confirm the table has been filled. As you can see, the table has been populated with two items. Let's exit the table and check on the CloudFormation stack. Let's view the stack outputs. Let's access the URL for the second API, which lists records. As you can see, the API returns the table data we just populated. We're finished with account C. Let's move on to provisioning account A. In this example, account A is a management account for the AWS organization that we'll delegate as the administrator for DevOps Guru. But you do not have to use the management account as the DevOps Guru administrator account. You can designate any account in your AWS organization as the DevOps Guru administrator account. For demonstration purposes, we've gone ahead and built a Cloud9 environment similar to account C already. We'll clone the same GitHub repository as we did for the other accounts. Let's view the files and navigate to the file named Enable DevOps Guru Stack Sets. We'll list the files again. From this list, we'll use the files named Create SNS Topic and Enable DevOps Guru for Account so we can view insights across all the accounts in the organization. Now let's create stack sets and stack instances to build the Amazon Simple Notification Service, or Amazon SNS, topic. This is an optional setup that allows us to subscribe to notifications for insights. Let's go to CloudFormation to check the stack's progress. Here are our active stack sets. Both stack instances have been provisioned and are current. Let's return to our Cloud9 shell. We'll create another stack set, this time to enable DevOps Guru from account A in accounts B and C. Once a stack set ID is returned, we can move on. Let's create the stack instances. We'll use this code to enable DevOps Guru in the region supporting accounts B and C. Let's check on the progress. Here we can see the second stack set. All three accounts in our organization are now completed. Now that accounts B and C are completely configured for our purposes, we can assign account A as the organization's delegated administrator for DevOps Guru. Let's configure the settings. We'll leave the default type set to monitor applications across our organization. Under normal circumstances, we would select account B, C, or another AWS account as the delegated administrator, following the AWS organization's best practice to use the management account, in this case, account A, only for essential administrative tasks such as managing accounts, OUs, and organizational level policies. For ease of demonstration purposes, however, we'll use our management account as the administrator. This account now has trusted access enabled. Let's complete the registration. Let's visit the dashboard. As you can see, three accounts are being monitored. All the accounts have a healthy status and no proactive or reactive insights. We left our applications running for a few hours so DevOps Guru could establish the baseline behavior of the applications we set up in accounts B and C. For demonstration purposes only, we then injected Lambda and DynamoDB anomalies on account B and C so we can view the insights that DevOps Guru generates as a result. We have now waited a few minutes for DevOps Guru to detect the anomalies. Let's see how the insights generated by DevOps Guru are aggregated in the management account. The DevOps Guru dashboard is a centralized location to view and analyze insights for all accounts in your organization. DevOps Guru has flagged account B and account C as unhealthy. They each have one ongoing reactive insight. Let's view those insights. Here we can see the name, status, and severity of each insight, as well as the account it is associated with and time it was generated. We can apply filters to view insights associated with an account. Account A has no current or past insights. We have now skipped ahead to when the anomalies in accounts B and C have been resolved. As you can see, our DevOps Guru dashboard reports no ongoing insights and shows all accounts with a healthy status. From the dashboard, we can search for accounts using their ID to get a system health overview. Let's view the Insights page. As you can see, both the insights that were reported earlier are in a closed state. We can drill down into each insight to view aggregated metrics and graphed anomalies recorded during the event. Lastly, when trying this setup in a live, non-production environment, all stacks and stack sets created in the three accounts should be removed upon completion to avoid incurring additional charges. You've just seen how you can enable multi-account insight aggregation with Amazon DevOps Guru. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.